So, speed pour spouts. You can use them for a lot of stuff. Did you know you can even use them to like pour drinks and cocktails and stuff by hand without having to measure it out? Who'd have thought? Maybe we should do that. You wanna do that? We'll do that instead. All right, today on Buff Drinklots, I'm gonna show you how to use speed pour spouts to freehand pour your drinks. So, speed pour spouts. What are they? Well, they're these things. If you've ever been out to a bar, you probably noticed that the whole bottle's got them in there. So then what it does is it makes the volume flow rate, or VFR, constant. So that way you can equate the volume that's coming out of the bottle with time. You can just count it out in your head instead of having to pour it into another measuring container. It's great. So why do bartenders use the speed pour spouts? Well, for one thing, they're faster. You can make drinks much quicker that way, and that way more drinks equals more tips for bartenders, so they want to make their drinks as quickly as possible. And for another thing, another bartending consideration is it makes less mess than pouring it into a jigger and then pouring it out, because you know, if the jigger gets everywhere, it leaves a ring, you slosh it all over the place, it's messy. And thirdly, swag. Just swag. It looks cool. Just done. It's pretty neat, right? You could have that feeling too if you get the speed pour spouts. And you can get these things just about in any big size liquor store. These are the most common type that you see in bars, so I like to use these because there are subtle differences. You get the cheap plastic ones that might have a slightly different VFR, which will change the timing somewhat, so you can get these. These are what the pros use. And now, I'm gonna show you how to use them. For this exercise, you'll need a pour spout, a calibrated jigger, go rescue a bottle from your graveyard, fill it with water. You don't want to use liquor to learn how to pour freehand unless you plan on getting really drunk from your mistakes. If you don't have a jigger, you can use an eighth cup measure, which is equal to 1 ounce. If you don't have an eighth cup measure, you can use a quarter cup measure, which is equal to 2 ounces. If you don't have a quarter cup measure, you can move out of your hut and into a first world country where we measure things when we cook. If you're smart, you'll do this next to a sink, but we're not smart, so we're gonna have a dump cup to pour the water that we measured into, all right? Okay, so there's a couple of schools of thought on how to do this. The way I learned is that each count is a quarter of an ounce. So that means 4 counts is 1 ounce. How long is a count? A count is not a full second. It's somewhere in the realm of like half a second-ish. You gotta figure it out. So it's really the only way to do it, and it'll depend on which spout you have, like I said. So, let's go ahead and figure it out. So this is a calibrated jigger. It's supposed to be very accurate. And we want to pour 1 ounce. This is the 1 ounce side. So we're just gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4. And that's an ounce. Isn't that great? It's wonderful. Here, just to demonstrate equivalence, get our eighth cup. And 1, 2, 3, 4. That's an ounce. And sometimes, you know, you make a little mess. That's okay, it's still less of a mess than if you use this to measure all the time. Then we got here, quarter ounce. How much is that? It's 2 ounces, so that's so that's an 8 count. So here we go, ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And just like that, boom, there you go. It's wonderful, isn't it? Isn't this so fast? This is so fast, you can feel. Just feel the speed. Feel the speed. I need this. Do note that the volume flow rate is only constant if you're at the maximum speed. That means you want to get it to the maximum speed as quickly as possible, which involves quickly inverting the bottle like so. Otherwise, it'll sort of piddle out, and then it's like you're not really sure how much you're measuring anymore because it's no longer precise. So just flip that upside down and be sure not to do that. Don't do that where I just did, just there. Don't do that and you'll be fine. Advanced technique. You see this little air hole here? Well, you can cover it with your finger to do a very, very slow, almost droplet rate, which is good for drinks that only need very small amounts of a liquor or liqueur, such as martinis. You like them extra dry? Use this technique so you can get just a few drops in there. But it's time to flip the tables into the world of practicality, because you're not gonna be measuring ounces too often. You're gonna be measuring a jigger. What's a jigger? It's an ounce and a half. When I say standard measure of something, this is usually what I'm talking about. So an ounce and a half, what's that? It's 4, it's a 6 count. So you just go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, And when drinks say, you know, a jigger or a standard measure, this is what they mean. So now that you know what a standard measure looks like, you can go out to your bars and watch bartenders and see how much they're pouring you. You can use your knowledge of pouring to know if they're pouring light or pouring heavy. Do this enough, and you can do it by rote. You don't even have to count out loud anymore. You can just do it through muscle memory. It's all about practice. So get out there and practice. So what have we learned about pour spouts today? They work by making the volume flow rate constant, allowing you to measure volume with time. Also, they allow you to make drinks very quickly and, with practice, very accurately. And when you know how to pour, you know how to watch other people pour. It means you can keep your bartenders honest. Lastly, but not leastly, swag. I hope this has been informative as well as entertaining. I'm Buffsalotl, and this has been another episode of Flop Chug Swallow.